Check. All right. So today, got two things that I want to talk about. One is the final project. Just want to make you aware of it so that we can, rather you can do it at your leisure. That is item number one. Just making sure that I have it up on Canvas. The other thing is want to go over an example of a numerical method solving for something that's solving for X at a value of Y that's not zero. So I just want to talk about that once. So I'm just publish the final project online quick, and then we'll get to work. Interestingly enough, you have most of what you need right now in order to do the final project. The only thing that you're missing is some graphing stuff that we'll cover shortly. It's not PM, there it is. All right, published, great. All right, let's get to work. All right, so last week we did a bunch with numerical methods. We talked about setting up an expression to be used in a numerical method using fixed point iteration as our means of solving that equation, which call it whole. We did some examples. We wrote data to a file, namely the residual history. I still think that fixed point iteration is like the coolest thing ever. Like if you ever get stuck on a problem in a class, like it ends up being something too obtuse to solve algebraically, you could conceivably just throw it into a code like this, solve it out so that you have a value in terms of itself, hit go, and just spit out the answer to you. It's pretty friggin' sweet. So I just wanted to work one more example related to that, and then we'll talk about the final project specification. As said, you have most of what you need in order to do the final project. If you wanted to get a head start on it, that's pretty much why I'm giving it to you now. Usually I hand it out like three or four weeks before the project is actually being due. No one usually works on it until a whole week that is due, but it's a try. I just want to make it available in case you want to do work ahead. So let's do this. Pop over to my folder. I've got all kinds of people online today. Okay. So, excuse me. So this is what we had last time that we already have our fixed point calculator for y equals x squared plus x minus 2 equals 0. In this particular example, we've added some relaxation to it, talking about how to use that to quote unquote calm down a iterative solution when it starts to blow up or when it doesn't converge. Which is going to be necessary for your final project. We also have implemented in this file a couple lines of code that'll write the residual history, or the convergence history. That's the word I'm looking for. So this is where we left off last Friday. So the thing that we want to change is that instead of solving for x when 0 equals x squared plus x minus 2. Let's solve for when 5 equals x squared plus x minus 2. What is, a question is, what is the value of x when y is some number that's not 0? So how would I go about setting up my equation for this? If this was 0, how would I